Now we are going to differentiate, or you can say we are going to sum up certain characteristics actually of alcohols and phenols. So now, like, if you talk about alcohols, you should know that all alcohols are mainly liquids. All alcohols are liquids, like at room temperature. And you know that, as I have already told you, I have just introduced you with alcohol, that alcohols are actually formed when we replace one H atom with the OH group. That means we are going to replace one hydrogen of the aliphatic compound, and we are just going to, instead of that, we are just going to add an OH group. So when we do that, we get an alcohol. And like, as you all know that if the bond is formed here, because in this actually the hydroxyl group is directly attached to the carbon atom. And you know that when the hydroxyl group is directly attached to a carbon atom, or whenever we take into account the bond between any atoms, there is a factor of polarity, right? So we are just going to focus on the polarity. So do you think that it is polar in nature? Yes, it is polar in nature, because you can see that oxygen is more electronegative. So that means it will be, pulling more electron pair toward itself. So we can say that the bond between the C and the OH is somehow polar in nature. This is what is the polarity, I think you can recall, which you did in the previous class, that is in the chemical bonding, that the atom which is an electronegative, it withdraws the shared pair more toward itself, and as a result, in a covalent bond, what happens? A partial negative and a partial positive charge appears. And as we know that if in a covalent molecule there is an appearance of charges, so obviously it possesses an ionic character, and that phenomena is something called as polarity. So we can say that, like here in this case, the OH is directly bonded to the C, that means there is a bond between C and O. So that means the O is more electronegative, must be attracting a shared pair more towards itself, and as a result it will acquire a partial negative charge and it will acquire a partial positive charge, the carbon. So that means there exists a polarity. So we can say that this bond is actually polar in nature. So now, and one more thing, if we talk about its acidic nature, I just forgot to write here, but I'm telling you verbally, that if we talk about the acidic nature of the alcohols, alcohols are actually very less acidic. They are even less acidic than water, right? So I'll just write here that alcohols are, like, as far as acidity is concerned, so water is more acidic if we compare it with alcohols, because they are somehow stable in nature. And as we talk about phenols now, so how phenol is formed, as you all know, that if you talk about their general existence, that how they exist in nature, so they are actually solids at room temperature. All phenols are generally solids, as they were liquids, but the phenols are solids at room temperature. And you know that how they are formed actually, as I have already told you, that they are formed, like here also we are going to replace an hydrogen atom, but in that case we were replacing from an aliphatic compound, here we are going to replace it from the aromatic compound. So if you replace an hydrogen from an aromatic compound and add an OH, it becomes a phenol. Again, we can say a phenol is a type of alcohol only. So, or you can say the alcohol in case of an aromatic compound is being given a special name, that is the phenol. Otherwise, it possesses different few properties, but the basic functional group remains the same, that is the OH group, that is the hydroxyl group. And if we talk about its acidic nature, so you'll be surprised to know that phenol is actually more acidic than water, and as I told you, that water is more acidic than alcohol. So this is actually, you can say, their order of the decreasing strength of acidity. So that means phenol is more acidic, and it is more acidic even than water. And you know that acidic strength is somehow the tendency to liberate in hydrogen ion or in hydronium ion, we can say that. So phenol is somehow more acidic even than water, and water is more acidic than alcohols. This is actually the, you can say, a strength or a order which they are following in the, if we talk about the strength of the acidity. And even like here also, if you talk about that, I told you that we can replace more than one H atom also, right? So if we are replacing more than one H atom from an aliphatic compound, we get mono, di, tri, tert kind of alcohols. Likewise, if we replace one hydrogen from the phenol, we get, if we replace one hydrogen from an aromatic compound, we get the monohydric alcohol. And if I replace two hydrogens, I get two OH groups. So that means I get a dihydric type of alcohols. So that means, depending upon the number of OH groups which are actually present in the compound, we divide that, or you can say we classify the type of alcohols and phenols into monohydric, dihydric, and trihydric. So see, look at the board. So as in this example, this is methanol, right? CH3OH. Here earlier my parent compound was CH4. I just replaced one H with OH and it becomes methanol now. Now it is a family of, it belongs to a family of alcohol. So as you can see that how many OH group it possesses actually? As you can see, it possesses only one OH group. So that means it is a monohydric type of alcohols. Now in my second example, just look at the board. I have 2OH directly attached to the C carbon atoms. So that means here one hydrogen from this and one hydrogen from this. If I just add them, let's see that what it becomes. Oops, it becomes ethane, right? So that means you have just replaced an hydrogen from the two carbon atoms of the ethane and you have just replaced it with the hydroxyl group, right? So this is what I did here. I just took out one hydrogen from one carbon and one hydrogen from other carbon and I just put OH instead of the, like you can say, I just replace it with OH. So that means as a result I get 2OH, so it is now a member of dihydric alcohols. Likewise, here what I get to see is, here if I add my H to it, so let's see what it becomes. It becomes CH3, CH2 and CH3. That means it becomes propane. So that means in propane, what I'm doing is from each carbon atom, I'm just extracting one H and instead of that, I'm adding one OH to each, right? So that means I can see this 3OH directly attached to the carbon atom. So that means it becomes a trihydric type of alcohol. So this is how you can divide the alcohol into three categories, the mono, di and tri, or it may be polyhydric also. That means it can have more than three also. Don't think like that I just wrote three, so it is only confined to three types. No, it can be a polyhydric. It can have as many of OH. The condition is that it should possess the replaceable, the hydrogen atom. So this is what is the alcohol, right? And the similar thing we can do in case of phenol also. So as you can see, this is my this is our aromatic compound. What I did, I replaced one H with the OH, and as this contained one OH now, so it belongs to a category of monohydric alcohol. Now, so in second, what I did, I just took one H from this place and one H from this place, because as we all know, this is all CH. This is all CH. Right, so I took out one H from this side and one H from this side and instead of that I put OH group. So now it belongs to a family of dihydric alcohol. Likewise, I took from three places, so it becomes a trihydric alcohol. So that means we can have as many of the alcohols, just depending upon that how many H replaceable hydrogen atoms are there. First thing is that, because there has to be a replaceable H atom. And after replacing that, we are putting an OH. So depending upon the number of OH which an alcohol or a phenol possess, we classify it into monohydric, dihydric, trihydric, likewise tetrahydric or a polyhydric kind of alcohol. So this is a basic, the characteristics about the alcohol and the phenol. So I think depending upon the number of hydroxide ion, I'm more concerned to it actually, that you should be familiar with it, that depending upon the number of the hydroxide ion groups actually present, we classify the alcohol into mono, di and tri. Likewise, we do it for the phenol, right?